Today, you're watching PTS English News. I'm Ethan Liu. So far, at least 11 people have been reported to have died after getting vaccinated. One senior citizen living in Kaohsiung developed adverse reactions 2 days following the vaccination and died in the hospital. His family members were agitated as they were not allowed to enter the hospital under the visitor number restriction.
A 90-year-old Kaohsiung resident was sent to the hospital 2 days following his vaccination shot. His family members were agitated as they were not allowed to enter the hospital due to the visitor number restriction. They said the 90-year-old man showed no immediate adverse reaction after receiving the COVID-19 vaccine on the morning of June 15th, but fell ill on the early morning of the 17th and sought medical treatment at the hospital.
可不可以见？昨天打了疫苗，一天没有，今天就发生状况。
The police kept trying to calm his relative after the patient died of myocardial infarction, as the hospital's preliminary diagnosis showed. More police force were dispatched to guard the hospital. The Kaohsiung City government has confirmed that the dead patient was inoculated with the COVID-19 vaccine. While more investigations are needed to determine if his death is linked to the vaccination, Kaohsiung City government's Department of Health said it would assist the family members with funeral arrangements and compensation application.
是否为疫苗不良反应，需要再进一步厘清，我们会请专家小组来审议。
Kaohsiung City started inoculating those aged 87 and above on June 15th with a vaccination rate of nearly 52% in 2 days implementation. 4,400 more people were expected to receive their jabs on the 17th. So far, 11 people are reported to have died across Taiwan following their vaccination. The city government says it remains unclear whether the death would affect the citizens' willingness to get vaccinated.
也是要尊重他的意愿啊，他要打，啊，我们才陪同。哎，啊，如果让他心里还不安的话，我说没关系，那我们就再等。
Some elderly people waiting at the vaccination site said they are still confident in the product. Meanwhile, another 90-year-old man in Tainan also suffered a sudden death after being inoculated.
我们报请司法相验，哦，也报请中央来查核是不是跟我们的疫苗有关系。
The son of the dead patient said he would not continue looking into his father's death as he believed it had nothing to do with the vaccination, but his old age.
The Food and Drug Administration recently announced that immunobridging will be standard for domestic COVID-19 vaccines. However, it's reported that US FDA said it's unacceptable.
The epidemic continues to rage in Taiwan. The Food and Drug Administration recently announced that immunobridging would be its efficacy standard for granting emergency use authorization for locally developed COVID-19 vaccines, including the one developed by Medigen Vaccine Biologics Corporation. It also indicated that this was done in accordance with the U.S. Food and Drug Administration's relevant regulations. However, it has now been reported that the U.S. FDA responded to Taiwan's FDA that immunobridging has no scientific standing. If phase 3 clinical trials are not conducted, Medigen's vaccine would not receive international approval.
美国 FDA 即将取消 EUA 标准的这个发放的这件事情，因为有许多的国际的大厂，他们的疫苗其实已经即将要申请药证，所以在这个部分的话，确实是对于国产疫苗未来在取得国际认证上是相当的担忧。
Foxconn Group founder Terry Guo recently announced he would like to donate 5 million doses of the Pfizer-BioNTech vaccine to the government. On June 13th, Health and Welfare Minister Chen Shizhong called Guo and promised his full support in procuring the vaccines. The process is ongoing.
知道国人对于疫苗输入的殷切期盼，必将全力以赴。
Taiwan's FDA commented on the U.S. FDA's response, saying it needs more time for confirmation. Meanwhile, Medigen said it will follow the FDA's regulations.
Numerous industrial parks have surveyed employees' willingness to be vaccinated, but the policy to exclude those who are not willing to receive domestic vaccines sparked controversy.
The Ministry of Economic Affairs has asked numerous industry associations to survey tech company employees' willingness to get vaccinated. However, the surveys conducted in certain Taiwan's industrial parks demanded to exclude those who are not willing to receive domestically made vaccines and those who would like to receive inoculation only to a specific product. The measure has been criticized by the Kuomintang. It believes it is like granting advance authorization to the domestic vaccines, which has not entered the third phase of the clinical trial, let alone receiving the emergency use authorization from the Ministry of Health and Welfare.
居然问大家，你愿不愿意打国产疫苗？不愿意的话，不能列册。这个违背了我们的呼吁，我们的呼吁就是不让国人当白老鼠，让人民有选择疫苗品牌的权利。打疫苗是人权啊。
In response, the Manufacturers United General Association of Industrial Park of ROC says it believes it's a necessary step in the preparations before massive vaccinations. Given the recent controversy over domestically made vaccines, the survey aimed to produce a more precise number of those who are planning to get vaccinated and avoid waste of resources such as vaccines and medical personnel.
就怕说国产疫苗比较有一些人比较不愿意打，所以我们才特别把国产的疫苗写上去。这个主要就是说，怕你的统计跟到时候真正施打的人数差太多。
没有说选择疫苗的情形啊，有这样吗？
没有，没有，没有，现在都没有看到疫苗啊，所以不会有选择疫苗的情形。
有时候请外老先打国产疫苗。
也没有这件事啊，他这个是望文生义啊，没有这件事。
The Industrial Development Bureau has also issued a statement saying that in the case of large-scale vaccination, people might not be able to choose the brand of their liking. Therefore, when the MUGA was surveying the willingness to vaccination, it had to take this fact into consideration. But it doesn't mean the association would require people who are listed to be inoculated with the domestic vaccine.
The Kuomintang and DPP butted heads during the second round of budget negotiations for the financial relief program.
The legislature is aiming to complete the third reading of the budget for the Financial Relief 4.0 plan by June 18th. A second round of cross-party negotiations was held on June 17th to discuss the 100 or so remaining proposals. The Kuomintang then submitted 300 more proposals spanning 10 issues, including ones related to vaccine procurement, rapid testing of the entire population, and national compensation for infection. It also proposed that locally developed vaccines had to pass Phase 3 trials before they could be administered, as well as a universal NT$10,000 relief payment. This meant that the legislature had to review 500 proposals in the one day remaining. The Democratic Progressive Party accused the KMT of complicating the negotiations. The KMT accused the DPP of arrogance.
行政部门要拿出诚意来，行政部门要谦卑地听老百姓的声音，听民意代表国会所转达的人民的请命的声音，不能够再高高在上，要不然就是摆出一副，要不然表决谁怕谁。有一天民意会反扑。
比较政治性的要保留嘛，比较没有办法妥协的，那就保留。没有说什么建情，要说全部改建情，有时候不改，就算了。本党自己的提案，我自己负责。
The New Power Party issued demands on vaccine procurement and the granting of emergency use authorization. It said the vaccine procurement budget stands at $34 billion, which includes the previously authorized budget of $11.5 billion. This differs greatly compared to other countries such as the US, Canada, Australia, and Japan. Canada has a population of 30 million and purchased 400 million doses. Australia, whose population is similar to that of Taiwan, purchased 100 million doses. It said the central government should have purchased more doses than needed, while simultaneously exploring the possibility of vaccine original equipment manufacturing.
南韩也好，日本也好，他都有，或者是说，甚至像在泰国、印度等等，都有在跟这些国际大厂代工的这个状况，所以应该是要来加紧来部署。
Legislators also said many groups have been omitted from this financial relief budget, including lessees. The Ministry of the Interior has yet to propose any type of rent subsidies. The epidemic situation remains severe, and companies are allowing employees to work at home in accordance with central government indications. Moreover, children can't go to school. As a result, household electricity consumption has skyrocketed. The KMT proposed freezing the electricity rate, while the NPP said the summertime calculation formula for households should be adjusted, and there should also be electricity subsidies.
Now, bring you some top stories from around Taiwan. Minister of Health and Welfare Chen Shizhong said vaccines do more good than harm and encouraged the public to get them despite recent reports of deaths of numerous elders following their vaccination. Gyms and sports centers say they were devastated by the closure order under the current Level 3 alert. Freelance personal trainers also complained they were left out of the unemployment relief compensation program. The second phase of Taipei City's online vaccination reservation has started, allowing those who are 80 and older and currently living in Taipei City to reserve their spot at one of the 238 locations. New Taipei City Mayor Hou Youyi visited a manufacturer of COVID-19 home test kits and urged the government to speed up the approval process.
New Taipei City is considering using general screening to identify those hidden and silent confirmed cases to prevent the outbreak from worsening. Mayor Hou Youyi visited a domestic manufacturer of COVID-19 home test kits on June 17th and urged the central government to speed up the approval process for home test kits to lower the cost.
So, 我们希望新北市也好，全国的也好，生产即将快筛的快筛剂品质的准确率能大幅提高到95%以上，更重要，价钱要便宜。
On June 11th, the FDA approved imports of three types of COVID-19 home test kits to Taiwan. It is expected that the test kits could be available on the market within 1 week at the soonest. It has been reported that some pharmacies have been privately promoting pre-orders of these home test kits online and claimed that the products would be shipped out by the end of June. According to the Department of Health Taipei, only Class 1 and part of Class 2 medical devices can be sold online. The central government has not yet announced the categorization for the home test kits for COVID-19, so they can only be sold at pharmacies for now. Those who violate the laws would face a fine.
那如果真的要在网络上贩售，也要等待它公告成为可于网络上贩售的医疗器材才可以贩售。那如果目前都还没公告的前提之下，有网络上贩售的行为，就是违反医疗器材法第17条的规定。那依同法可以处30,000-100,000的罚款。
The Department of Health also suggests people who want to purchase the home test kits to visit a physical store so that professional medical personnel can instruct the correct way to conduct the test.